What's up, YouTube? It's your boy, 207 Nano Reefin. Not too much to talk about. Nothing's changed, which is good. I did a water change yesterday. Probably one of the longest water changes I've ever done on this tank. I really took my time and manually took out a shit ton of algae. As you can see over here by the blast. You can't see the blast though because the rock's in the way, but there was a ton of algae over there. I got that out. I got most of it behind the rock, Zoa rock. And there was a ton on the sand bed, so I just took my tweezers and manually picked it out. But yeah, that's really about it. I did get two new pieces of coral yesterday. My buddy needed room on his frag rack, so he gave me another forest fire digi, which is the red one you see right in the middle, right there. And then the bubble gum, I'll get a close up of that. It's small. It's a small little frag. But it's behind the SPS rock. It's back there. So I'll get a close up of that. He gave me another forest fire just in case the one that I fragged doesn't make it. I think it's going to be all right, but I don't really know. So we'll see. Like I said, I can still see some polyp extensions on it, and it's not completely white, so I think it may be all right. I think I just stressed it out way too much. But I mean, that's really all I got to really talk about today. I did a water change yesterday. I haven't tested anything yet. I'm gonna wait until tomorrow. Actually, no, I will test my alkalinity today, and then because I like to test the day before and the day after my water change, so I'll test my alkalinity today. Other than that, nothing. The clowns are starting, I believe, to home the Duncan. I think that's what she's doing. She's burying her face in it. It almost looks like she's biting it, but I don't believe she is. She's just burying her face in it. Now the Duncan doesn't like it at all. It's never had anything in its area before. It's never had anyone try to home it, so. But I think that's what she's doing. I've never heard of a clownfish eating coral. Like I said, I really don't believe that's what she's doing, but you know, we'll see. I'll keep an eye on it. But that would be cool, because I'm not going to lie, I've been trying real hard to get those. That's why I put the dunk in there, so she could home it. So, well, they could home it. So I'm hoping. But yeah, I guess I'll just get a close-up of the tank. Like I said, it's going to be a real short video today. I'll get a close-up of the tank and sorry about that. So there's the Duncan, the Lepto, the Acans, the Blasto. As you can see, the Duncan's not happy right now. One of them is closed right up. This is the bubble gum right there. Give it a little focus. Come on. There it is. That's the bubble gum. I had it up on top of the rock, but I think it was getting pounded with flow, and it just didn't like it. As you can see, the forest fire loves it right now. Wicked good polyp extension. I'm hoping that skin turns green real soon. And the other forest fire, you can see right there, it's not completely dead. You can see some polyp extensions on it. So I think it's just stressed. Great color on my rainbow acro. Love that fucking thing. Look at the forest fire, guys. Look at that polyp extension. Beautiful. I can't wait till the skin to turn green. Oh, sorry. Orange shirt, probably not the best to wear. The skin's turning green on my Poslopora. That's awesome. Just about every branch is green now besides the lower ones. See if I can. There we go. But yeah, this is everything, guys. Mushrooms are loving it, dude. Look how open these things are. Look at that. That's about the only spot I didn't get yesterday, right there. I should have grabbed it. Candy cane. And my clown Gobi just chilling on it. That's where he lives. But yeah, look at the mushrooms, guys. I have not seen the mushrooms this open in a long time, so whatever I did yesterday for the water change, they seem to like. Look at that one. Just flattened right out. Trying to get that one to go on the rock. I don't think the snail shell... Hindsight, I don't think the snail shell was a great idea, but... This is what it is. You live and you learn, you know? But that's the tank, guys. Don't forget to comment, like, subscribe. Oh, question of the day. I kind of want to know what you guys are running for equipment. What do you guys run for a light and wave makers and anything special for filters? So that's the question of the day. What do you guys run for equipment? Excuse me. I run a Nycrew 100 watt for my light. I run two Higers, run one Crossflow and one, I think it's just a Higer wave maker is what it's called. And then I don't have anything special for filtration. It's still the stock return pump. And the only thing that's different about this is I don't use the sponges that it comes with now. I took them out and I use media baskets. And I run filter floss, carbon, bio cubes, and I think the last chamber is a matrix. But I'm not 100%. I'd have to ask my buddy. He gave them to me and I should know, but I don't remember. I'm pretty sure it's a matrix though. But yeah, what do you guys run for equipment? And don't forget to comment, like, subscribe, answer the question of the day. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a good day.